Well, we are at it again, but this time we are in Debian testing. And if you go onto Debian's website and you actually, or just Google Debian testing ISO, you can get your own ISO that already are running off the Debian testing repositories. Just so you don't think that you have to install stable and then roll over to testing. Not needed, friends. But there still seem to be a lot of confusing among people that are Linux literate that still think that Debian testing is massively outdated. So let's see how outdated it is. As of this day, June the 14th, 2022, when I recorded this, we have 5.18 for the Linux kernel. Fedora don't even have this. It's still in testing. They're still testing it. Okay, I think Arch have it, I think Tumbleweed have it, but there's a lot of other distributions that don't have it. And you should look at Debian testing a little bit at a Fedora. It's an aggressive upgrading release. So you get the latest and greatest as fast as possible. And you jump repository every time a new release of Debian comes out. People tend to think that Debian testing is not really being done anything with up to like 6 months before the new Debian release is coming out. No. Debian is kind of like the semi-rolling release of Debian. Just like, you know, you can debate that Fedora is kind of a semi-rolling or static release. It is a static release, but it has some software get updated in a rolling format, but you still have to jump repository. That's why we call it a static release. But Debian testing is more what Fedora actually is. So if you like the upgrading method, the continuous aggressive updating that you get with Fedora, but you want that in a Debian world, you should be running Debian testing. So let's go into the good old Synaptic Package Manager. I don't want to install a shit ton of software here. I just want to basically show you guys what it is in here. If we go up to search here, let's do Firefox. They are running the ESR, that's the long-term release of Firefox. So they're not running 100 or what it's called, but it's 91.10. And I can't remember what the latest version of that is. So if you go in here, it's released May this year. So we are not that far behind. Again, I'm sorry for the lighting in here. I have a little bit of lighting issues today. So it's not that old, to be honest. Let's look at Cinnamon. We are at 5.2.7. Not that old. Let's look at GNOME. GNOME session here. Yeah, this is the one, 42. So they already have GNOME 42 in their repository. This is Debian testing. This is not Arch. This is not Tumbleweed. This is not even Fedora. This is Debian testing. Let's look at XFCE that don't get updated that much. So if we go, probably have to go all here down. 4.16. What else can we look at? KDE. Yeah, I think they are running 5.24.5. And I think that's the latest Plasma desktop also. Debian testing. If we are talking release numbers, they tend to be just as updated as Fedora Linux. Sometimes Fedora get it a little bit before, and sometimes Debian testing gets it a little bit before. Debian testing tends to run until they release a new release of Debian, so let's say 1 to 2 years. But the Debian testing continues just like Fedora continues. The thing is that Debian testing is giving the name of the new release that they are working on, called Bookworm, is the new release that will come out. So if you put Bookworm into your source list, you will run testing. Or if you just put in testing instead of a release name, you will also be running off testing. If you're running Debian and you're running Debian stable and you need, let's say, a newer version of LibreOffice, you can use backports. This is where backports comes from. They comes from in here. It's actually coming from Debian testing. They are then being used for backports to give people that need newer version of the hardware. Like, I need a new feature that's in the new LibreOffice, and I can't wait until the next version of Debian comes out. So therefore, you can use Debian backports to then backport in software from the testing repository. And then, when a new release of Debian is coming out, the Debian testing repository is kind of freeze for about 6 months. You don't see much upgrades to be going on for Debian testing in about 6 months. Because then they are, like I said, they are freezing Debian testing. And then they are testing the living shit out of it. You know, they're throwing everything in the kitchen sink at it to check the security aspect, the stability aspect of the software that's already in Debian testing. And when that is up to Debian standards, and they've done that for about 6 months, sometimes longer, sometimes shorter, then we get bookworm. And then Debian testing will then get the release name for the next release. And then they're doing the same. Then they're up till like 6 months before the next release, they're just continually updating Debian testing so people can backport in software into the stable release. Because I also hear a lot of people, oh, you should not use Debian testing because it's really unstable and unsecure. You do know that when you're backporting shit into Debian, you're running, basically they are taking the software from the Debian testing repositories. They are making sure it runs on the current Debian. So sometimes they need to modify it a little bit. And then they run it. So in my humble opinion, it's maybe not... Let's say Debian stable is 99% secure and 99% stable. Debian testing may be 95%. Because they don't put in the same amount of work, of course, as they do to Debian test stable, sorry. But it's fucking close. So I just want to basically clear a little bit of confusion about this whole Debian thing, because there's still people who think that Debian testing is keen to Fedora Rawhide or you know, unstable in other repositories or other distributions. It's really not. It's really not. That's what SID is for. SID is basically Fedora's Rawhide. You know, it's their developer branch. Testing is where they are basically making sure that it's as stable as it can be. So before it goes into testing, it already needs to be secure and stable. And then this is like the last stop where most distributions, they go from unstable to then release, where Debian have this testing repository in between to basically make sure that you get this extra stability, this extra security. Most distributions will say that the software that's in Debian testing is production ready for them. Most distribution, even most enterprise distribution. Ubuntu is based mostly off Debian stable, not so Debian stable, Debian testing and Debian SID, their development plans. And then they fiddle around with it to make it a little bit, you know, make it Ubuntu, because Ubuntu is not Debian, but they fiddle around with the packages so it's Ubuntu compatible. And maybe they tweak it a little bit to be a little bit more optimized for the Ubuntu base. And that's it. See you all later. Bye-bye.